Good morning, dear students. Welcome to our online classes. Now we are in the present 8th standard social class. In the previous class, we already discussed about that Jainism and Buddhism. What are the major reasons to rise like these religions in the world, especially in India, especially in Bihar state? So many reasons are there. Yesterday, that means in the previous class, we already learned the major reasons for to rise the Jainism and Buddhism. Now it is the time to discussion with you, that is Jainism. Before, when Vardhamana Mahavira not entered into Jainism, how is the situation in that Jainism? We have to understand in this class. So we have to understand here, it believed in, it means here Jainism. Jainism believed in the existence of 24 Tirthankaras. Tirthankara means what? Do you know about that? Tirthankara means everything sacrificed person. A person who is sacrificed everything. So he is considered as a Tirthankara. So that means hermit. In English we have to consider as hermit, or in Kannada, in our mother tongue, we have to consider as sannyasi. Like that, we have to understand. But everyone, we should understand about that. Vardhamana Mahavira was not the founder of Jainism. That is a true. That is a true line. But here, who is the founder of this Jainism? But Jainism believed that 24 Tirthankaras are the founders of this Jainism. Those are believed that the existence of Jainism to remove the social ills from the society. That is the main thing in their concept. That's why we have to understand from this class, Jainism originated with the 24 Tirthankaras. Just for example here, the next point we have to understand here, Rishabhanatha was the first Tirthankara. We have to believe that Rishabhanatha was the founder? No. Vardhamana Mahavira was the founder? No. Who was the particular founder of this Jainism? Jainism believed that 24 Tirthankaras ideas are their preaching ideas. It developed the religion like Jainism. But here, after they enter the Vardhamana Mahavira into Jainism, it more developed there. That's why we have to consider him. He is the father of Jainism, or he is the founder of Jainism. So, who was the first Tirthankara of Jainism? Rishabhanatha. Rishabhanatha is the first Tirthankara of Jainism. The next one, Parshvanatha was the 23rd Tirthankara. In rest of 22 people as considered as Tirthankaras, but not mentioned in your textbook. If that information you need or you want means, you have to search in Google. But here, just we have to understand, Rishabhanatha is considered as the first Tirthankara, and Parshvanatha was the 23rd Tirthankara. Just we have to little information given in our textbook about Parshvanatha. Who was Parshvanatha? If question arises in your mind, means you have to answer to that question. That is, Parshvanatha was the 23rd Tirthankara, and he was the son of Ashvasena. Both are lived in the 8th century, that is considered as BCE. BCE means what? Before Common Era. In that before Common Era, both are lived there. Who are the both? One is Parshvanatha and one more his father, Ashvasena. Who was the father of Parshvanatha? Ashvasena was the father of Parshvanatha. And what are the four principles he included in their preaching to the through the Jainism? Means he preached four major principles. One is the first one, non-violence. Non-violence is the first principle preached by Parshvanatha. if any person don't violent to another person, so if we are not able to violence to another means we have to follow the non-violence. So it is the first principle. The second one, truth. Truth is the second principle preached by Parshvanatha. We are always speaking with each other. Truth. If we are not used in our life, lies. Lies are little bit happiness are given. After that, they are given us long pain. That's why we have to understand the second principle of Parshvanatha is truth. The third one is asteya. Asteya means not stole or steal. We don't steal anything from the others. If we are doing like that means we are not human beings according to Parshvanatha. The Parshvanatha's third principle is asteya. Asteya means what? Not to steal. The last and final one, fourth principle is aparigraha. Aparigraha means not to own property. Not to own property means that is a property of the others. We don't make it our own. Why? Because we are not able to take that ours. It is that is their hard work. That's why they are made that property. That is their property, not ours. That is considered as aparigraha. Aparigraha means we are not able to own property, receive the own property of others. That is the meaning of aparigraha. So, in this class, we have to understand Jainism had 24 Tirthankaras and Rishabhanatha was the first Tirthankara and Parshvanatha was the 23rd Tirthankara and he was the son of Ashwasena and both Parshvanatha and Ashwasena are both lived in the 8th century BCE and Parshvanatha preached four major principles. The first principle is non-violence. The second principle is truth. The third principle is asteya. That means not to steal. The last fourth principle is aparigraha. Aparigraha means not to own other property. So these four principles preached by Parshvanatha. In final stage we have to learn Vardhamana Mahavira. After the entered into Jainism, he blessed one more principle, that is Brahmacharya. So totally Jainism had five principles. One is non-violence, second one is truth, third one is asteya, fourth one is aparigraha, the last and final one Brahmacharya. Who joined Brahmacharya principle to the Jainism? Vardhamana Mahavira. Vardhamana Mahavira joined that fifth principle in the Jainism religion. So in this class we have to understand the entry of the Vardhamana Mahavira before, how is the situation in the Jainism religion. In the next class we have to in detail information about Vardhamana Mahavira. Thank you.